Hello students, my name is Sunaina and I'm here to teach you the subject of social science. Today we will be learning the first chapter in the subject of sociology. The name of the chapter is Social Stratification. What is the meaning of stratification? Strata means layers. Social stratification, of course, will mean the layers in our society. How can there be layers in society? Layers in the sense groups, male, female, senior citizens, the upper class, the middle class, the lower class. There can be so many layers that can be made in the society. This chapter will talk about all of these kinds of layers. Let's look at it. There is a lot of social inequality that exists in a society. The people are stratified or they are made into layers according to various qualities. What are these qualities? It can be gender, male, female. It can be caste. There are four castes: the Brahmin, the Kshatriya, the Vaishya, the Shudra. It can be profession, like you may be doing a job in the agricultural sector, you may be a businessman or woman, or you may be in the service sector or in manufacturing and so on. It can be based on class, upper class, middle class and the lower class. It can also be based on race, the Asian race, the Indian race, the Caucasian race, the Indian race, the Dravidian race, the Aryan race and so on. So all of this is proof that there is social inequality. We will be learning in this chapter in detail about all such inequalities. We will also learn what are the steps that have been taken and that should be taken to bring in more equality. Students, what are these social inequalities? They are because of sources of income, education and professional opportunities, access to health facilities. If you are in a rural area, you may not have access to a very good hospital where a heart transplant surgery can take place. You would probably have to come to the city for that. And political representation in the government bodies and political participation. Very important question from examination point of view. You should know at least two among them. So this means that social inequality is already there. And how does it increase? It increases when we provide unequal access to material, resource, income and opportunities. So for example, if we neglect public health, public education and social security, the poor are the ones who are going to suffer more and more. Why? Because the rich can still go to private hospitals, to private schools. But what about the poor people? They cannot. So this allows the assimilation or accumulation of wealth in hands of very, very few. There is an increase in the economic growth. There's an increase in the GDP. You all know these terms. You all have studied the chapter of development with me before. They have led to the creation of 50 billionaires and 1 lakh millionaires. But there is a neglect of food and social security, of caste, income and sex-based discrimination. All of this makes inequality very evident in society. Students, now we will learn the first topic of education and inequality. Education being equal for all citizens of a country is very, very important. Our constitution has a lot of articles that ensure equal opportunity at education. Now, we will see each and every one of them in detail. Social justice means there should be no student who is denied education. All students of the country must be allowed to have access to education. So, where is this social justice mentioned in the constitution? In two places, in directive policies and in the preamble. Preamble is a document written in the starting or in the beginning of the constitution of India. Then, in the article 39 of the directive policies, it is said that by providing social justice and people welfare, this is the duty of the state government. After this, there was an amendment made. Amendment means change made to the Indian Constitution. Which amendment? 86th Amendment. It has inserted an article called Article 21A. This article has made education compulsory and free for all the children from the age group of 6 to 14 years. There is also a directive, Article 45, which says all children under 14 years should be provided with free and compulsory education. Whereas Article 21A has made it a fundamental right, Article 45 was a directive or a direction given to the government. The next one is Article 19. What does it say? The right to speak and the right to express one's own opinion is the fundamental right. It is the duty of the Constitution to protect the welfare of the opportunity less minority children. So, this article ensures better opportunity or encourages the state government to create more opportunities for the minority children. There is also the Article 29, which provides for the protection of cultural rights of the minorities. And Article 30, which provides for the establishment of minority education schools. For example, when you go to Northeast India, in the hinterlands or in the inlands of Mizoram, Nagaland, they are allowed to have schools to teach their own culture according to their own cultural traditions along with modern education. And the article of the constitution provides for the same. Article 46 clearly expresses that it is the duty of the government to support the education interests of the scheduled caste and the scheduled tribe as well. In support to this, a lot of reservation has been made for members of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe in various educational institutions of India. The Supreme Court's decision to understand the right to live of Article 21 from education perspective is very, very important. By declaring school education as a basic right, the Supreme Court has redefined the efforts to provide school education. So, not just says free and compulsory education, but has also encouraged that the education must take place at school. So, this decision, what has the Supreme Court done? It has provided a new hope for so many children of India. This judgment came in the case of Unni Krishna versus Andhra Pradesh under the Article 21A, that getting free and compulsory education by all children between age of 6 and 14 is the fundamental right of the children. The name of the case, the article number and the detail is very, very important. In this decision, the court has also said that the entire education structure, whether it begins from the Anganwadi to higher education, it should be seen as a holistic perspective. So, the entire education must be taken into consideration. It should not just be like only primary, only high school, only college, or only master's. the entire education of a student must be looked at, and adequate support and facilities must be provided for a child to successfully complete the same. As per this decision of the Supreme Court, all the citizens of the country have the basic right for education. And now education is a right under the right to life. Right to life is under the Article 21, and right to education is a part of it. It is a part of the right to live as per this decision of the Supreme Court. But inequalities in opportunities in education are on the rise due to various legal issues. There is also rise in inequality due to differential economic standards. See, this child can afford tuitions, can afford better services, so has more access to education compared to this child who has to struggle to basically just get to school. Still, efforts to eradicate unequal opportunities in the field of education are on with the help of the constitutional provisions. So what all we learned? So what all we learned, students, in the first topic of inequality in education? We learned what are all the constitutional provisions. We began with social justice, where education is ensured as education for all. We learned about the fundamental right. We learnt about its mention in the preamble, in the directive policies. Then we went to learn about what are all the extra provisions in the constitution for education of the minorities. Then we learnt about the cultural rights. Finally, we had a detailed discussion on the Supreme Court's decision in the State versus Unnikrishnan's case. And finally, we are moving on to our next topic, gender inequality. What is the meaning of gender inequality? Inequality on the basis of classifying the gender. If someone is male or female, the kind of access or the kind of facilities they get just because of their gender. It could be from the very starting stages of life, like in education, later in work opportunities, and even in very other basic things like in nutrition, access to food, and so on. Now let us look at gender inequality.